sometimes it's a central theme, sometimes that's a supporting theme, but in reality, if the information related to the relief or position really puts the information as being used in a level of context. Now, there's some, again, large forces at work here. One is there's a fundamental paradigm shift from our point of view as a company, is one of which we're hopefully contributing, but the paradigm shift is the replacement of traditional techniques with much higher productivity solutions. It is our view as a company that in many of these applications, whether it be construction or agriculture or other large industries, that it is possible to achieve a paradigm shift in terms of the level of benefit in construction. It is our belief as a company that it is possible to reduce the cost of a project, of a construction project, by 25 to 30%. Not by the implementation of point solutions, individual technology solutions, but the holistic application of technology. There is a ground here of incremental adjacencies. Once the basic technology infrastructure is in place, it's possible to extend it into adjacencies. An application in which Trimble is involved in is agriculture. Agriculture has seen a great benefit from the initial use of positioning, GPS positioning, once the investment on the farm has been made, the GPS technology is to apply it to new adjacencies and to achieve something that is an effective connected farm, where the farm is now being driven by information that is geospatial position-centric information. Emerging economies provide the potential paradigm of a skipping multiple technologies, something that I think many in this audience are participating in. And finally, technology is an enabler. The integration of positioning wireless and software technology has created entirely new field solutions that simply did not exist 5 to 10 years ago. The other element is one of so putting these changes in context, what has changed? I think that if you look at the context of the geospatial professional, many things have changed many times rapidly in the last 10 to 20 years because of technology. First of all, the issue of place. Where is the work done? Many of the activities that required in past times, collection of data in the field and bringing it to the office, well, technology has enabled large parts of that activity to take place in the field and without bringing it back to the office, allowing real-time decision-making, real-time quality checking, but where the work is taking place has changed dramatically in the last 10 to 20 years. The source of information that has come up this morning, which is in traditional usage, it was the source of the information was a dedicated professional in the field using very rigorous procedures. Increasingly, at the far extreme anyway, the issue of the source, issues of crowdsourcing or alternative sources of the data are increasing. So it calls into question issues of quality, consistency, and the like. And the issue of the source of the data is central. The data integrity, again, in past times, it was a very rigorous process. When you get to engage in a diversity of new sources, the question is, what is required? The standard increasingly will become a standard of sufficiency. The data is good enough for the application for which it's being used. The issue of access. Historically, proprietary databases and rigorous control of the data. Has been assumed, but basically ongoing, many data applications, many data repositories are going to be free and ubiquitous available to anyone. process for many, many different applications are using the data, and it's really embedded in more vertically oriented processes. The frequency, again, the idea of version control set of data is becoming harder and harder to contain. It's dynamic, and the issues of, again, control and consistency become important issues. And then, ultimately, in a more profound sense, who has influence? Times past, it was a professional who really provided a professional service, provided the advice, provided the conclusion. Increasingly, new constituencies, whether it be the owner or the user of the data, but new constituencies will have more and more ability to interact, to engage, and will have increasing performance. The issue of the Internet of Things is applied to geospatial is becoming more and more real, which is embedded in a model, embedded in a, typically a three-dimensional model, usually a centimeter level accuracy. Again, the idea of the model becoming integral and ubiquitous. The benefits of this are lengthy and not worth reading here because they are well known, but again, technology is advancing and enabling a wide set of benefits that simply were not accessible at times in the past. The issue of work process in terms of level of sharing and collaboration, both enabled but then also required as the geospatial information embedded in more and more work processes, more and more vertical work processes, there is a requirement for a higher level of collaboration that involves new constituencies, which simply have not been part of the traditional geospatial constituencies. Now, this is a Trimble-centric view of the world. These are the vertical applications in which Trimble is engaged. All of them have at the center a model, and that model is very much a geospatial-oriented model, but the proliferation of uses beyond the traditional uses of geospatial information have enabled us as a company to engage in a large number of applications. The actual work tools are rapidly expanding as well, again, driven by technology, enabled by technology. Up in the upper left-hand corner, you see some of the traditional survey instruments, whether it be a local station or a GPS system, but the form factor, the tool that's available for the GIS professional, for the surveyor, is proliferating and becoming even more so. If you will, smartphone or phone will increasingly be a part of this as a horizontal capability that's available to everyone, but at the same time, the emergence of sensors that can create new capabilities also enable specialty form factors, specialty capabilities to be more or less plug and power in many of the tools of the surveyor or the GIS professional. That requires something other than traditional businesses as usual. Sort of thing. There is a transformation undergoing and it will require new ways of approaching. And the definition of geospatial professional will continue to work. Driven, in this case, I guess, mandated by the emerging technology. Previously, with discrete steps, discrete process steps performed by professional, with explicit handoff results, the next element is that the geospatial data, geospatial context, will be embedded in the data structure of other data elements as part of the discrete process, and there's a need to understand how to integrate that. And in that, it comes to the opportunity set, both the challenge and the opportunity set for the geospatial professional, which does something other than the traditional role. It does have the need to question conventional wisdom, conventional ways of doing things, but again, gas opportunity for having more and more of an impact. So again, the thing is, technology is coalescing at a rate we have never seen before as a society, as a global society. It will have, continue to have massive effects, and the benefits of us all are profound and transformative. Thank you very much.